The symmetric deflation is quite benign with this glider. It's very safe, 1-2. It's gonna collapse, it's gonna swing back marginally, and it's gonna swing forwards, reinflate, and fly away, no more than 45 degrees to the horizon. But what are the scenarios that we're gonna get where we're gonna have a bigger deflation possibly? Okay, not just from normal stable flight. So those two most common are a speed bar, when you're on speed bar and you have a massive deflation. And also, if you're spat out of the thermal and the glider dives forwards, that's another sort of deflation you might get. So let's do the first one. Let's do a speed bar. So I'm putting on my speed bar now. Okay, first the first stirrup. You could probably see the pulleys going down. And then I'm going on to the second one. So now I'm on the full speed. And you'll be able to see the wind noise is going to get more. All right, and now I'll have a symmetric tuck and we'll see what the glider does, okay? So reach up, and as soon as you have a deflation on a speed bar, you get off the speed bar quick. Get back to trimmed flight. Okay, now hit a bit of turbulence, have a deflation. Fuck. There we go, falls behind, let it fly forward, slight horseshoe, slight turn, but it's always forwards, it's always diving gently, so it's fine. Now, quite positive, although it looks quite scary, big deflation, the minute it goes from behind to in front, you know it's okay. So tiny application on the brakes and just monitor that progression of recovery and you're fine. Don't panic, that's the key. Don't suddenly go oh, like that, because it'll make it really violent and go into a big cascade of problems. So just let the glider come over your head, let it dive, and just check that dive. If it's going into a turn, it doesn't matter, it's banking. So then you just monitor that bank, that roll, and wait, you know, wing over and brake back onto your safe course. So I'd like to show you just about the pitch of a wing and how good a symmetric tuck is, because if people have this sort of horrible thing, oh, symmetric tucks. They're good, they're actually a safety valve, because your glider, if it didn't symmetric tuck when it came down to a right angle, then it would be dangerous. It gains energy and you can fall into the sail. What you want to do is, if you don't break the dive, obviously, is the glider dives and it symmetrically tucks and you fall past it, it reinflates and you fly away. Okay, let's do another one now, as if the glider's been spat forward. So to create that, to cheat that, if you like, we're going to do brakes. So we're gonna brake, dive, and then deflate it on the dive. So here we go. So we brake, let go, as it dives, deflate it, buff. So that's happens, the deflation on the dive. And that's quite stable because it happens on the dive, you've got that pendulum to recover you as well. So now we're gonna do a symmetric tuck. Now this glider, higher aspect ratio, bigger deflation, bigger fallback, and the hovering before it dives is quite acute, especially if the ears stay in. Okay, so we'll see if we can demonstrate that. It'll horseshoe and it'll be quite slow, but you've gotta just watch the hands, you've gotta brake, just monitor that dive forward, okay? So here we go, I'm gonna go forward. I'm gonna grab symmetric tuck. Oh, it's quite physical. There's a lot of load on this. Okay, good. Just gently brake it. So now it's deep stalling slightly. I let it dive forwards and I let it fly. Okay, so I'll do another one because that sort of hovered because the horseshoe is so big. Okay, here we go, ready? And poof. So hands up, it's dropping, slightly opening now, hovering. Now it's diving, let it dive, let it recover. See, the ears are in, but pop them out one at a time. Don't pop them out together, just one and then the other. Don't be in a rush. And you want that lovely flow of wind in your face. If it's quiet, then you know it's not great, okay? So keep your hands up when it goes quiet. So in this example of a symmetric tuck, you can see the deflation coming in, glider dropping back slowly, starting to inflate from the center, but as it dives with big ears, it starts to drop back into deep stall. You can see this by the reflex coming in the wing there. Now, if you just keep your hands up, let it dive forwards, get a reassuring dive, and gently brake that surge, and it flies away nicely.
contrary to what we say with the safer end gliders, when you're flying high performance wings and you have a massive symmetric tuck, it's very important to quickly jab on the brakes to stop that symmetric tuck getting any worse. The minute it starts to recover and dive, then your hands should be up again, letting it dive and monitoring the recovery. But there is always that pulse reaction of a quick jab of the brakes, and that should be instinctive of a pilot flying that standard glider.
So we'll do it again, another demonstration. So on goes the speed, so we want to go really fast. So here we go, full speed, symmetric tuck, much more violent, off the speed system, the glider horseshoe swings back, flies forwards and recovers straight away. So you can see that the difference is quite a lot. Okay, so that was good. That was a nice one. And it's still stable, but it's a lot more violent, but the recovery is still there too. Okay, let's do another one now. Let's do a dynamic one. So I'm gonna just brake a little bit. Good, and let it dive, and then pull a symmetric tuck. So there it is, it's in. Gently brake the dive that comes. Just weight shift to my right a little bit, and then pump the brakes out. Tips come out, no problems at all. And I miss the cameraman, which is an advantage. There he is.